Hello, everybody. It's Tuesday of Villains Week, and today we're going to be drawing Scar. He's one of my favorite villains from the 90s, especially. And I drew him 100 times when I was a kid, and he was always really difficult. So today's going to make a lot of weird drawings. We're going to go through it pretty thoroughly, but just be prepared. Be prepared. It's going to get weird. For those of you who are wondering who this might be for, this is for anyone who wants to learn how to draw or have an hour where they can just be distracted from everything outside. So since we're learning how to draw Scar together, there might be some weird drawings along the way. Don't throw it away. Get to the end of the drawing, and I promise it'll make more sense once you see the whole thing together. So first off, I'm going to start cleaning up my hands since our tools have been in the drawer for a bit. We're just going to make sure we start clean. I'm excited to teach you how to draw Scar. He's a pretty complicated character, but I think there's a simple way to break him down, so I hope I found it. We'll find out together. The tools that I'll be using today, I have my black dark overline pencil, and then I'm going to use the blue again for the underline, and that is because the same character was it was animated by the same animator who did Lilo, and he always works in blue, so I'm going to try to do the same thing. His name is Andreas Deja, and we're going to learn a little bit more about him along the way. So let's just go ahead and move you over to the desk. And you can see right off the bat, I have the paper turned vertically because I'm going to draw it pretty big and I want Scar to fill the page. Sorry, just want to make sure I focus. There we go. Okay, so the first thing we always do is we put our circles up in the top corner of the page. And what that does, that just helps us warm up our arms and make sure that we are starting properly on this drawing. The nice thing about doing this too is that it helps muddy up the page a little bit, so it's not, you're not so worried about making a perfect clean drawing. This is just gonna be one that we're learning on. So animators' desks are constantly just smothered in papers of figuring out how to draw a hand or a nose, and it's never perfect the first time, and it's rarely perfect ever. So you want to make sure that you give yourself a chance to learn. If your drawing looks weird, you're probably doing it right. So another thing that helps us while we're working forward, just so you can see, if I start darkening some areas once I've decided that these are the shapes that I like, then I can get these other blue lines to sort of fade away into the back. And so the nice thing about that is that we can work really rough with the blue, and then the black lines will help give us some more clarity at the end. And Scar has a lot of big dark shapes like Pete, who we drew yesterday. So just show you here, once we start darkening more, it's even more defined. So I think it's gonna be fine. So Scar has a lot of angular shapes, but they're still kind of based in the Disney round principles. So I'll break those down for you one by one. So we're just going to draw the head of Scar, but he has this great big mane that's going to take over a lot of our page. So we want to leave room on the sides for his ears, and he has a little bit of hair on top. So I'm going to draw my circle right about here. I'm just working it out. When I first drew it, it was kind of like a weird oval. I want to make sure it's the shape that I want to move forward with, so just working out those lines. So Scar, excuse me, anyway. Scar is going to be looking straight at us. So I have this ping pong ball to show you how those lines on the face are meant to indicate that. So since he's looking straight at us, we're just going to have the vertical line going straight vertical and the horizontal line going straight horizontal. And so he's going to be, the middle line is going to be a little lower than it is on the ball, but this just shows you where we're coming from. So to draw those lines, I always do full strokes with my hand. If I go slower, then it can get a little wobbly here. So just quick lines right down the middle. I'm going to actually bring it a little lower to the bottom because we're going to use that to draw his muzzle. And in a horizontal line, I'll just put right about here. Let's see if you see it. Okay, so as is often the case, we're going to start with the nose, and that helps us anchor the face because it's going to be right in the middle. And for us, for Scar, we're just going to draw right in this bottom left quadrant. We're going to draw kind of a slightly diagonal line going out that way. And same on the other side. And now we're going to draw from the ends of these diagonal lines to the middle that we drew. Then we just sort of roughed in the top of the nose. Connect these lines with a rounded line. It kind of dips lower at the center and then comes back up over here. And there's something too that's specific to Scar that we want to make sure that we get, and that's his nostrils that kind of come down in these points off to the side. I'm just going to round it out here, and then bring it right back up. They're kind of like slanted, curvy V's. So the drawing we're using is the model sheet, and this is put together by Andreas Deja, who is the animation supervisor. I said that earlier, and he helped design the character into animatable shapes. So even though there are a lot of straights, it needs to work dimensionally so we can turn the character around. So he had the final say in the design. Then he works with a cleanup artist to make it feel finished. So right about, we're gonna go a little bit below the nose using the center line. I'm just gonna draw some straight lines coming out this way. It's gonna be his mouth. I've made those a little thicker in the middle than they are out to the side. Like a boomerang pointed up. And then now I'm just going to connect these to the nose. So this is this area when we start coloring in is going to be all black. Okay, so now we can start working on the outsides of his cheeks. So starting about where we had this nose here, the nose line, I'm just going to do another diagonal line that points a little farther away. Coming back around, and then a really straight line that goes towards the corner of the mouth. Doesn't touch the corner of the mouth, but it just starts going towards it. And you can be really scratchy with these lines too. They don't need to be perfectly lined up because they're all fur, so it's okay to be scratchy. That's what I tell myself. Let's do the same thing on the other side. And we're just going to start indicating the chin shape. So even though he's looking right at us, it could be the same on both sides. I'm going to make it a little different. You can see that Andreas did that in the model. So I'm going to round this side out over here and kind of get a straight on this side. So I'm just adding a little bit of detail on the side of his face here. And this is all fur, so we can just start We're gonna do this differently when we have our when we have our black line. Okay. We should have the bottom of Scar's face. Okay, so now we can start building out the eyeballs. So I'm gonna actually begin with the eyebrow just below this center line and then to the left of the muzzle. I'm just gonna start drawing a curved line that goes up and then really diagonal. It's gonna have some angry eyebrows up to the top here. And it kind of hooks around to the outside of the circle. The same on the other side. The thing interesting about, I only realized this recently. I don't remember if I confirmed it, but I'm pretty sure it's true. Halfway into this song, it sounds like another voice actor comes in to sing a part. The character of Scar was voiced by Jeremy Irons and he sings this song. But I think there's one part where I think I read somewhere that he blew his voice out or something and they had an actor come in and do just sing that one line, and that actor was the actor we talked about yesterday, Jim Cummings. He also was the singing voice for Powhatan, which is Pocahontas' dad, at the beginning of Just Around the River Bend. You can hear a little bit of Winnie the Pooh in that. He's a versatile voice actor. So right about here, where we have the diagonal line cross the horizontal line, I'm gonna start drawing his eyes, and his eyes are kind of weird shapes. They're like almonds that are slanted. So if this is horizontal, they're like over tilted up. And I'll just start that here. Shape a little bigger. So that's a tricky shape. I'll just let you guys work that out a little bit. I'm going to darken the outlines of it. So they have these really dark patches on the insides of their eyes and then on the outsides, specifically Scar. This song is not appropriate for this drawing, but we're gonna keep it anyway. See what happens. So now I'm gonna do the other eye. I'm always looking back and forth, trying to make them the same size. Almond shape that comes up this way. More flat on the bottom. Jim Cummings did not sing for Olaf. That's all Josh Gad. Snowman. So now we're going to draw the
bottom of his eye mask, which is a simple shape. It's gonna be a diagonal line starting here, and then another one coming out to the edge. So it's like a little, you're making a triangle with this horizontal line. Gonna thicken up the eyebrow here. Give some little hairs. So this part's gonna be colored in black. Starting from the corner of the eyebrows to down here, I'm going to draw kind of a straight line, sort of cut off the edge of their circle a little bit. So now we know where to put his scar. He wouldn't be a scar if he didn't have one. So we're gonna draw right at the point here, a little triangle that goes underneath. And it's rounded because it's wrapping around the skull here. And then the top part of the scar is up here. It's on his right eye. Sorry, his left eye, the right eye on the drawing. So start outlining the top of the circle here. I'm gonna stop in the middle because he's got, it's called a widow's peak, but it's similar to the Mickey shape, that V that's at the top of the hair here. Not a lot of similarities between Scar and Mickey, but this is the one. And then he's just got these hairs that are up top, so I'm just gonna kind of softly indicate that. So we can work out those shapes later. It's always fun to have one kind of branch off here. So these are going left, but then there's one that goes right. Okay, so now we're about ready to do his cheeks. So starting from about here, we just want to draw a curved line out to the side. And then it's going to come up and tuck in right there. He's not smiling. So they're not poofed up and they're not making his eyes. There's no cheek lines up here. Same thing on the other side. I just added a little bit of detail there. Of course, when we go in with a black line, it'll be even more detailed. And now, I think we're ready to start on the mane. So, outside of the hair, I'm just going to draw some lines like this. Just rounded lines that kind of follow the arc of the circle here. If you were to see Scar from the side, he has this, that's his nose. He has this, he's kind of like a, it's like a sideburn almost. This way. And then his ear comes out from that sideburn. Not a great drawing, but so what we're gonna be drawing is, this is that sideburn right here, just from the front. So behind that sideburn, we're just gonna draw his ears. And those are really simple. It's just a straight line that kind of goes diagonally down and then it rounds back into the sideburn. Now we can start building out the top of his head. This part's simple. You just go from to the on the left ear to the left of the sideburn line. I'm just gonna go up and then kind of roughly round up to the poof that we have up top. Same on the other side. And I'm just going to draw straight through just to keep the lines consistent. But when we outline, this line will be in front of this one. We won't see this. And that comes through over here and over here. You could just start arcing it back because it's going to tuck in to like a little tuft underneath the chin. So I just want to show you the full shape so you can put that in yours. Simple lines, since we just did a hard one. Let's give him the inside of his ears. And those are just some rounded lines that start towards the top and kind of round out down towards the bottom. And now to kind of work out his hair, just gonna draw some big shapes that will eventually break up into smaller shapes. Almost like a hand. See that? Fingers. It shouldn't look like a hand as you draw yours, but just something to think about as you're drawing it. And just giving him some little hairs. Now I just want to work out some last details in his eyes. So starting from this line, I'm just gonna kind of give him another line that goes up that just shows his eyelid, and he's got a tense stare. Okay, so now the last thing we want to do is his eyeballs. He has really small pupils, and he's going to be looking right at us. So I'm going to give him his irises here. Again, just like Pete, he's not going to have a shine out of his eyes. He's not a happy, helpful character, so we want to make sure that we show that in his eyes. So I'm going to start really small and see if you want to go any bigger with it. For the pupil, right in the middle. Little dots in there. And that is our underdrawing for Scar. So before we move on, I want to show, I have this book called Archive Series Animation. And there's a series of books, animation, design, story, let's see, backgrounds, layout backgrounds. But in here they have a bunch of animation drawings from different films. And I wanted to show you how he Andreas has drawn Scar. You can just see he uses the blue, and it's really scratchy because he's working out the motion of the character. So we're doing a much cleaner drawing than a typical animation drawing. But when you see something like this, it's not that he doesn't know how to draw Scar. He decided how to draw Scar. He designed him, but he just found quicker shapes to tell exactly what he needs to show the emotion of the character. And then a cleanup artist will help make it feel consistent. So there's a lot of really nice stuff in here, obviously. He's a great artist. Andreas started at Disney, I believe in the 70s or 80s, and he loved doing zoo drawings. So you can see that Lion King is a perfect fit for him. There's a lot of information about him online. You should look him up. Andreas Deja, D-E-J-A. All right, I'm gonna start outlining my character. So to do that, I'm gonna start on the left side of the drawing because I'm right-handed, and that way I don't smudge the lines as I move my hand across. We're gonna be coloring him in too. So there's another trick that I use that you've seen before to help me with that. His mane is black, so it helps to just use black. I like keeping these lines really loose. It's okay that they're not perfectly sharp. Remember, they're hair, so it's a little lighter. And if you're unsure about the line, this is a great space to do kind of quick practice lines. So I mentioned it before, but Andreas animated Lilo, who we've drawn. He also animated Stitch. Nope, that's not true. Sorry, he animated Hercules, Lilo and Stitch on the mind. And he animated Gaston, King Triton, obviously Scar, Jafar. A lot of really classic characters. Goofy in the How to Hook Up Your Home Theater short. Make sure there's pretty light eyes. I'm just going to start lightly shading that in. See, it really comes to life once you start adding these black lines in there. So these lines that we're drawing, they're not eyelashes, they're kind of like the part around a lion's eyes that are black. He doesn't really have eyelashes, it's just sort of a design shape. Something I've learned from doing a bunch of these kinds of drawings is that, you know, as you're drawing it, you might think something that you've drawn is distracting or because it's not perfect. Then you go back and look at it at the end of the drawing, and there's so much happening in the work that it's hard to even see what bothered you in the first place. And that's even true in animation. There's a lot of times where I will animate a shot and something I did bothered me, whether or not like the weight on the character doesn't feel right or something. And then I see it in the film at the wrap party and it goes by so fast that I always think, what was I bothered about? I don't even remember what it was that was an issue. Because we're in animation, you're slowing down time and you're slowing down perception. Because an animated film is 24 frames per second. A frame is basically a drawing or an image. So you're really belaboring slow motion. But when it plays, characters really just, or the audiences just relate to who the characters are. So that's why it's important not to throw away your drawing halfway through, because you'd be doing so much work on the drawing that the thing that bothered you might not even be an issue. I think that's what happens when everyone says, like, actually, by the end, it kind of looked right. I go through that too. Like, when I first drew this, I was wondering if maybe his eyes were too close together. But I'm not bothered by it now. Last thing I'm gonna do is the hair up here. And even if these lines aren't right, it just looks like little hairs that are coming off, so Scar isn't like perfectly groomed. He's got a little roughness on him, so actually works in his favor. I'm gonna darken the nose first before I start coloring in the mane. I have so many weird drawings of Scar in my childhood sketchbooks. Just trying to figure out how to draw him. Like that Scar, so I'm going to start just coloring him in. And with that, I'm just going to be darkening in the mane. And use the side of my pencil because that helps me cover ground a little more quickly. Also gives a more even texture to it. Run out of lead on this black pencil. It's dangerous. I started fanning it out. If you saw the direction of my hand there, started going like this because I wanted to get to these little guys. Even though we're drawing it on a flat sheet of paper, it still should feel like a dimensional object. I've seen a lot of really good shading from people out there. As an animator, we're not really concerned about shading. A lot of our focus goes into emotion and design. And then there's whole other departments of people who are great at coloring and help make it feel right. In the computer world, that's called the look department. And they work on all the textures of the characters to make them feel real, or just whatever the design is for the film, whether they're supposed to feel realistic or stylistic. They're wizards. So, and this isn't really about Scar, but on Frozen 2, I was the supervisor for Sven, but I was also the supervisor for Queen Iduna. And she has a gorgeous cape. Like a, there's the shawl, but there's also like her actual dress. And the back of her dress has this crazy stitch pattern on it. And it's the look artist who worked on that actually designed embroidery and even the direction that the threads go and how many threads there are. And it's crazy. A lot of the scenes that she's in, it's really dark, so you can't really tell what's happening there. But if you have a second to pause it and appreciate her work, Nikki Milley is an incredible artist. She also directed one of the shorts. Her Short Circuit. Check that out. So there would be a whole department of people who are meant to make this hair look right. It would look better than the way I'm doing it, but I just have a dying color pencil. And they're much better than the other. Okay, and then now, shading-wise, I'm just gonna shade in his eye mask. We've talked about that area a bit. Not as dark as the hair. A little shadow on his iris. See that iris? Over here, I think this got pretty close to the same darkness, so I'm just gonna make the hair a little darker here, just around the edges, to help separate it from this shape. Okay, so before we're done, I wanna color in the scar, and just like Andreas, who colored it red, that's what I'm gonna do. So I have a red here. And there we go. That scar, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, be sure to sign your drawing. I'm going to do that right down here. And there we go.
Cool.
I will transfer this back.
We did it. I hope you feel good about the way yours turned out. I hope you saw in the drawing too, just making sure we're in focus. And we are, great. The hashtag Drawing with Woodsy is a great way to share your drawing with other people online, me included. Just cleaning my hands off with that hand sanitizer. You can share it on Instagram or Twitter. You can tag me in it at AnimWoodsy. And if you put it in your stories, I can share it to my story. And then at the end of the day, you just click through my stories and see everyone's drawings for the day. So it's been fun to see how everyone has interpreted these characters and the things they add to them. I'm looking forward to seeing your scars. Don't forget to sign it and then share it online. Thanks for joining me today. Remember, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. And I appreciate you spending your Tuesday with me. So I guess I'll see you tomorrow for Villains Week Wednesday. Bye now.